Just,
all right.
I think that's
bye.
Better.
Shut up, Pluggy.
Also, my so-called 8-bit life.
Yeah, dude.
Night attack. I love you.
Dude, Mitsula wins the title belt. He wants to call it vowel movement.
Vowel movement.
All right.
Perfect, right?
Can the people who do the Google Doc, the show doc, would it make sense for us to put the title selection on the Reddit, on the subreddit? Like, because I know we have a live discussion thread where people talk about the show during and after, but would it make sense to have, like, the top comment be, like, the title so people can vote it up and down, or are we deciding?
No. I think it's a bad idea for...
Because we'll just get fucker right in the pussy for every episode.
Well, I mean, there's that, but also it's like, it's sending everyone to a clubhouse on the other side of the internet, you know? And it's like, we should keep it closer in-house. Do we have a problem picking titles
No. I guess maybe I was just thinking of another thing to do with that live discussion, just because people seem to like it. I guess I don't know. I'm just thinking about, because like, I'm so excited about how the Reddit's kind of grown up.
Yeah,
I don't know what we should suggest people should do.
Yeah, absolutely. Hang on. Crash, you're on. What's up, bud?
Hey, guys. I just really want to apologize to everyone for subverting your show to do this silly little bit that I had.
It was great. It was actually awesome. And what was awesome is I could actually feel the moment you recognized that it was off topic, and I felt you doubling down in that moment, and it was great because you just plowed right forward, and it's like you doubled the energy and the rage, the righteous rage against anyone who would besmirch the reputation of the Ponyville
Phillies.
No, for real
though, Crash. Like I had no other way to plug the fact that we're doing a live episode on Saturday, and like if I was smart, I would have somebody do exactly what you did, and you did it otherwise. So like, I owe you for calling in and doing exactly what you did.
Our in-studio audience is giving a thumbs up right now. Brian says that he enjoyed it very much.
Hey, seriously, I would love to plug the Ponyville Ponies. The only
fucking Philly weirdo. Pony, fucking, no, I'm hanging up. Fuck you. You don't talk about fucking a horse on my show.
Fucked up, bro. Fuck
yeah.
Up.
Fucking you up, plug a Philly? You can take that to some weird-ass shit. Fuck you.
All right, I'm gonna refresh here, and then we will sit down and hear the story of the ad dragon.
Oh my god, this is gonna be great. Okay, good. Yeah. Stick around. Let's do. Oh, what's something that we can? You know what? I'm just gonna play an old classic. I don't think I played this on the live. Maybe I did recently.
Breakdown.
Yeah. Yeah. Boop, 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 boop. Okay, we're going to get story time, and so I got to play something here for a moment just to get it going. Allie, you going to hang around with us?
I might stick around for a bit. Okay. I don't know if you can tell, but I'm, like, sick.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, no.
All right. Well,
look, I'm
going to
mute this shit. We'll be right back. I want to blame Miss Allie Spagnola. I don't want to blame you, but I want to tell you that I just had a grown man pour cinnamon whiskey into a perfectly good Miller Lite because I wanted to know what that would taste like. So I'm having a whiskey and beer. I don't know if that's a thing. Probably shouldn't have done that. No. Yeah, I'm good. Hey, Justin. Hey, y'all. Oh, it's Liz.
Seriously,
don't.
No.
All right.
Like, cerrar la boca.
Oh, you know what? I'm sorry. Allie was muted. Normally,
sí, señor.
Normally, Allie is would be on a different channel than Justin. But they're both on the same channel. Ooh, man, I can't wait to revamp this. I can't wait to get a decent soundboard. Well, I think Justin
soundboard.
Oh. Soundboard.
Soundboard.
I'm gonna have to. Man, there's so many things I want to talk about. Number one, for our Skype double ducking thing, I think I'm gonna have to get a new soundboard to make it easier to send you back a better signal. Also, you saying soundboard made me think of just how unfathomably drunk I got at South by So Wasted. That was really
we got
thing.
Really wasted. Yeah, we got super fucking drunk. Almost as drunk in a shitty segue. I don't know. We should have got drunk and we got really we got in trouble at Twit.
Yeah.
And there's an element to that story that we have never shared on the show perspective.
Yippee!
And that is that of Liz, who has only recently just left the network, used to be somebody that had to deal with our horse shit, specifically as it relates to this guy, the
end
dragon.
I hate that mask with a passion.
What? Okay, but you don't have to hate it anymore. Now you can...
No, I can cherish it and love it and just fully embrace the Mexican wrestling-ness nature of it.
Which... So... Let's go back to the beginning. At what point did we at NSFW come on the radar as like fucking up
a problem
mail route?
At which point? What's that?
Mail route. When you guys did a fan did a little music video of your guys' mail route.
Do you remember the name of the music video?
No, I blocked that out. Just like I do a lot of traumatic episodes in my life.
So
my therapist thought it was a good idea, so I just kind of went with it.
How would you describe the mood inside Twit when this music video? Because I assume we have a lot of friends in Twit. We're friends. A lot of other people that work there.
Yeah.
I assume people were passing it around because they liked the show and they thought it was funny.
Oh, they thought it was hilarious. Yes, they did. Plenty of fans sent it to us, and we got to be like, oh, joy, look what just sent over. Oh, joy, look what the just got forwarded. Yes. No. Gosh, no. Spam is a red. I remember trying to bury this. We tried to, like, they tried to bury this so badly because of I was not happy about it.
All right, so everybody's laughing because, and by the way, I had always heard that song was like inappropriate because you didn't know whether or not the boner was for or against the rape. And I feel like that video does a really good job of illustrating that this boner is anti-rape.
It's
this
an
is
anti-rape,
an anti-rape boner.
It's yeah, no, it's like, hey, bro, not cool, rapist spam. You need to go away. Fear the power of the mail route boner.
For stopping rape.
Yeah. All right. So I would imagine that was a bit awkward.
So you mean talking to the advertiser
after that? No, you say
that they tried to bury it. So this was a negative thing in the eyes of Twit.
Yes, because it was immediately associating. It's like, oh wait, so the advertiser is sending this message about
boners.
Yes, or exactly.
Yeah. As a good defense.
No, exactly. So it's like, so they're paying for this and talking about this, and this is the message they wanted to put across.
So how would you, as in your position at Twit, what would you, if you were to guess our reputation before the spam is a rapist ad aired? But were we known as good ad readers?
Oh, hell yeah.
Okay.
That was the thing. It's like you guys had such the crowd source like behind you. It's like, no, that was the thing that was about sales. Like, no, these guys have a diehard, like just core of fans where they will support this. They will get her done, as you want to say, and just freaking, they're going to only support good stuff. So they will do this. So that was the thing where MailRoute was, they wanted specifically to be on this show because they knew how good you guys were about picking your advertisers and putting it across in the fan group you guys had. So and then that music video came and then all shit hit the fucking fan.
So how were we looked at after the music video?
Basically, as do you know that movie that came out? Was it the 90s? It's like Killed the Babysitter. It was kind of like that afterwards.
Don't tell mom the babysitter's dead.
Yeah, it's kind of like after that where it's like, okay, you guys have to have like a legit babysitter after that. It wasn't kind of like, you know, like a teenage girl who is like still trying to find her way and was going to have like a boyfriend over and they were going to do something in the corner and, you know, well, Joey and Diana were upstairs sleeping. It's like, no, you need a legit person who had like security checks behind them.
We were looked at as liabilities.
Pretty much.
Okay. And we needed somebody to scream.
I think that might be my favorite moment is the literally side mouth as she goes for a drink. Pretty much. I'll just hide in here for a moment.
One second.
I know. Listen, let me ask somebody who has a pedigree in viral music videos. Allie, have you ever seen our spam as a rapist video before?
I did not, and it's just changed my life.
Did mine too.
I'm just sending that to Fandango. That's my next video.
Did you hear that, Justin? She says she's sending it to Fandango. That's her next video.
There we go. Okay. So now, what is the edict that comes down from on high on how we are to be handled in terms of our ads?
And keep in mind, we don't know. We're just, you know, I feel like this is the Joker defense. Like, we wouldn't know what to do with success if it came to us. We just, you know, we're just a dog running around on a chain. And so in this case,
just
you know,
got so happy to get something in your mouth, you just didn't know what to do.
Right, exactly. Oh. So Twit basically says like, these guys can't be trusted.
Yeah. So what is the process? What is laid down? What is the new way to handle the NSFW ad problem?
Screen them.
Okay.
Screen them as though, like, you know, someone, you know, when you call a 1-800 number and they're like, just this, so you know, your call will be recorded for customer service quality. So blah, 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 blah. It's like, it pretty much came to that point where you guys had such great ad reads that so appealed to your audience, but necessarily wouldn't come across the best way to the advertisers.
So, in your mental checklist, what were the hot buttons that you were looking for each time that you would go through? Or was it just a gut check?
There's so much to say in so little time.
And then again, just to paint the stakes here, the problem is that people, we were a very low downloaded show in comparison to the big shows that got a lot of the big ad buys. But because we drove like social interaction.
Super.
Twit would often, and correct me if I'm wrong, they would often put us with big accounts, despite the fact that our show did not deserve to be in the same league as some of the other shows that got them. Right.
Because reliably, we could make a louder noise. I think it's safe to say that outside of This Week in Tech, we could be reliably counted upon to make the biggest noise out of anything on the network, would you say?
Yeah. No, you guys had a big social background that just anything you guys said.
Listen, here's the thing. 12 of you motherfuckers listen and you all tweet. And that's all that is.
I'm very aware of that. I don't know how many people all of a sudden just tweeted and emailed your ad like, look what they did with MailRoute. This was awesome. It was like, shit. Really?
Well, and what's funny is
so many places we have to delete and say we have to report this. Oh, no, we don't want to have that be anywhere.
C222 suggests that you join the conversation with hashtag night attack, hashtag MailRoute, hashtag spam is a rapist.
So as it was happening, I would like to point out that we weren't entirely ignorant of the fact that there were other parties to please, because I remember sending an email to Tom like, hey man, this is what the fans are doing, are you cool with that? And Tom writes back like excitedly, like, I don't know.
Like, oh, this is Tom the CEO. Yeah. Tom the CEO of MailRoute.
Yeah, so, exactly.
And we've talked in the past about our interactions with MailRoute, but let's keep this the focus of this story here in the cottage. So there is a system in which
we're now
our editor, Tony or Anthony.
It switched to Anthony.
He would let you know whether or not something was.
No, we had to review them all.
You had to review them all.
Mm-hmm.
So you would watch.
They couldn't his post unless we reviewed.
All right, can we
all
talk
the shows?
Can we talk through the ad dragon thing? Because
hold on, wait a minute. All right. Let's get to it, because I think there's a transformation that happens. But just to give people context, of all the shows that Twit produced, how many had their ads reviewed?
You guys kind of set a new standard where all ads have to be reviewed now.
So we fucked it for everyone.
That's amazing. It kind of created a whole new role of continuity checks. So before any editor could actually publish a show, we have it so that every single ad is now checked.
So okay. this is our legacy. You know, you wonder if you live.
You created a whole new job market. You actually create a position. You make it so that food is on the table for somebody now.
Exactly. Bob McBob says job creators. We brought jobs to the podcasting industry and we can do it again.
Out of the corner of my eye, I see somebody in the chat shout, click, clack, ass snack. And I look down and it says Allie Spags. God damn.
You're welcome.
I think this is what we love so much about Allie, is that she's kind of the physical manifestation of so much of Chat Realm.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, I'm honored.
So we are being reviewed. We have changed the paradigm of the way that Twit ads are. And then there is one specific ad that, again, flags the attention of
powers that be.
The powers that be, as well as the ad, the people that actually like pay for it. This was our Squarespace click clack ad, and that was the one that we got the email for, that I was banned from reading ads.
I actually did block that out.
What?
Well, I truly blocked that out.
I believe I could be wrong on this. I could swear that Click Clack was first and Spam is Rapist was second.
No.
The mail route was first. I remember that.
All right.
I truly, honestly did and then, black out the Squarespace.
Well, I think that really wasn't a review thing though. That was something like they got pissed off about that. And then that was Squarespace legitimately got pissed off about that. They came back. I get banned from meeting ads.
Right.
Uh, So anyway.
It's going great. Okay, so the click-clack happens, and for the record, certainly we did not mean any kind of social commentary or satire or anything like that. We just
picked... I mean, we're dumb. We're dumb people, and we do dumb things for laughs. Like, yeah. We are literally, like, we are an audio... If lighting your own fart on fire for everybody would played play, for audio, right. We would do it. Like, that's the level of fucking discourse we're on.
So in this case, it was basically, you know, everything we do is a bizarre metaphor, and once we... get it, we just run with it. And in this case, we compared or Justin said that and this is the funny part, is you get blamed, Justin, but it's me who sealed our fate. You were the one who started doing the bit saying, like, Squarespace, that's a gun store, right? And and me, in an effort to back your play, you know, we go through the whole ad about how you keep thinking Squarespace is a gun store, and I keep trying to explain it's a fast, easy, reliable way to post your blog portfolio or any other website.
Yeah.
And then at the end, I'm like, why don't you tweet them, click clack. And so that all explodes. And then Squarespace tweets back, click clack. And then they're
not
like,
not knowing
that,
happening.
That we're,
they're then
and
later
unfortunately,
pissed. We legitimately pissed off. Like, and again, let me preface all of this. Okay. That, I do not blame Twit, and me or Brian blame Twit at all for anything.
No.
Like, there is literally no element that Twit did at any wrongdoing. We have fucked up on every element of this story, and we are being dealt with by very patient people. Very patient people from the top down who are just like, we like the curiosity that is your show. We are genuinely fans of your show from management down. We would like to keep you on the air, and it is for your own good that we are A, reviewing the ads, and then fucking pulling me off. Like, it was for our own good.
Right.
That is what happened. Now, we reacted to it because I was fucking piss and vinegar indignant about fucking being pulled off the ads, and I decided that I was going to...
rebel.
Well, I was going to solve the problem the only way I know how, which is the way that pro wrestlers have solved the problem of being banned and kicked out of places for low decades.
Keep in mind, like
return the next week in a mask.
Our dynamic is there's a lot of trust that happens. And as we discussed it beforehand, I was like, all right, how are we going to do this? Like, the one thing we didn't want was for Justin not reading the ads to be like a big thing, right? We certainly didn't want to turn it into an us versus them or
a lot of, yeah, because we didn't want blowback to come back to Twit.
Right,
all.
Right. Like, because that's a cheap, easy way. I mean, that's what all of Howard Stern's career was, right? Was demonizing his own boss and getting everyone to make a lot of noise. We didn't want any of that. We didn't want to demonize our own bosses. And so instead, you know, we wanted to make it a way to where organically we could take Justin out and make it happen. And then Justin had the idea, like, what if I read it in a and this is the way it was pitched to me. Justin said, what if I read the ads totally straight and actually just focused on everything? No, nothing that could be offensive to any of it. But I did it in a pro wrestler mask and we introduced a new character called the Ad Dragon, which sounded great. And I said, yes. And
yeah. All right. Here we gotta wrap this up. We gotta wrap this up here. We will catch up on it. But all I want is this. We just need you saw the Ad Dragon thing, and what was just your first gut reaction?
What the fuck?
As it should be. All right. Listen, guys, I will be right back. But we gotta wrap up. Liz and I has gotta get out of here. So
drive back to Petaluma.
Yeah, they gotta get back to Petaluma. So we are up against time here. But I'll be right back. I'm gonna mute the board and then we'll be back.
All right. Well, here. In the meantime, there's that. So I'll just chat with Miss Allie Spagnola. Let me see if I could put Allie Spags in place of. Hold on. I don't have a split screen with the two of us.
Yeah.
Yeah. Way to go, jerk. You suck, Brushwood. Let's do this, and then I'll maybe switch to that. Hold on. Wait. Watch this. Hold on. Look at that. Boom! Take that, Richard Dawkins. That's going to be my new catchphrase. I just proved God's real.
sad I'm going to miss Nerdtacular. It seems like it's going to be sweet this year.
Yeah. I was telling Justin that there are two big events that are the biggest things for us every year. It used to be just Dragon Con, but now it's also Nerdtacular, which we totally love. But I don't know if you know this, Allie, but suddenly found out I'm going to take a 2.5 month vacation in Los Angeles. Do you know about this?
No.
Yeah. No, I'm going to go to Los Angeles because I feel like it's important that I be away from my family and just stay in Los Angeles for about 10 weeks, you know, get in early July, leave like early, you know, September, give or take. This sun bun. I like that that tag right there. I've got to drop everything and go do that. But unfortunately, you know, the vacation takes priority legally over some other commitments. When I signed a contract with my vacation and said I will come out to you and spend time in Los Angeles for a while, my vacation might say things like, I don't know that you could go to Nerdtacular because, you know, I feel like you should show up early so you can get ready for your vacation. We don't want you coming to your vacation the day your vacation starts. We want you to come to your vacation like fresh and like ready to go. We don't want, you know, if you're going to drive out to your vacation, that's going to be like, you're going to be tired from the day before. And we don't know how good of a vacation you're going to have. So I hope all of this is translating.
Not everyone else gets it but me, I'm sure.
I don't know. Ask yourself why I would take a vacation in LA away from my family for 2.5 months.
Yeah, no, something big is happening. It actually just hit me. Wow, I'm an idiot. Okay, awesome. Freaking awesome. I'm an idiot. I can understand why your vacation might need a little headroom in the beginning.
The vacation may have said to me through the spirits that be, like, I don't know that you should go to Nerdtacular. And so what I told the vacation is, let me come in early, like a week ahead of time, and I'll get in that vacation groove. You know, I'll start, you know, my vacating, and then like I'll fly out to Utah to do Nerdtacular, and then I'll come back and it'll just be like we're continuing on the vacation and everything will be cool. And the vacation said that he would take it to the other vacationers and see if it worked out. So we're hopefully everything's cool for Nerdtacular, and we'll see. I also looked at the schedule of my vacation and I noticed that I'm vacating really hard right before and right after Labor Day weekend, but apparently I'm not vacating during, you know, I'm not taking it easy during that weekend, and so I might be able to rush out to Dragon Con for like a day, basically, and then I got to get back to my vacation because it's very important.
It's very important to relax. Wow, that's nutso. I hope you can make it to Dragon Con. Wow.
Yeah. Are you going to be at Dragon Con? What's your story?
Oh, duh. I'll be there.
Amazing.
I would be a Nerdtacular, too, but this is crazy. I have to sing the national anthem on national television.
Holy crap. Hold on. I just realized that my Raspberry synced up with the refresh rate on this. Hold on. That's the best thing ever.
That's crazy. Someone GIF that immediately.
It's GIF, and I'll hear nothing else on the subject.
That's terrifying.
Are you doing like a dubstep bass drop?
No, I noticed that like I just blew a raspberry and it exactly synced up with the refresh rate on the camera. And I got this awesome like bizarro duck face there.
I hope everybody understands this is what Brian will be doing for the rest of the night. Like, long after this live stream ends, he's just going to be looking into this fucking monitor and giving himself the fucking ghost duck face.
The ghost duck face. That's what it is called. All right, here, I'll mute myself so it's even better. You just talk like you're being interviewed.
So did I hear that you're singing the national anthem? Focus, Allie. Yes, focus. Come on. We got to keep this going. So you're singing the national anthem. Like, where are you doing it?
For a lacrosse game in Ohio, the Ohio Machine. And it's going to be on CBS Sports as well.
That's amazing. Is this the first time you've sung the national anthem on live television?
It's the first time I've sung the national anthem ever.
Are they going to announce you as the Power Hour lady?
They want me to play a Power Hour before it, too. So there's like a joint ticket thing where you can come to a Power Hour and then walk to the game.
To a lacrosse game, yeah. Nationally televised lacrosse game.
Which is nonsense. No one's actually going to watch it. I mean, my mom will. That'll be nice.
Well, this is no way to keep this fucking job, Allie. Like, you can't run down the sport and the client like while... you're trying to get paid. Mind your manners. This is a professional show. We're doing a very professional interview with professional singer Allie Spagnola. Allie, when you're singing the national anthem, how are you focusing compared to the feedback? Because I've always heard that is a really big element of singing the national anthem.
Huh, I didn't know that, and thank you for telling me. What is that going to be like... Is that going to be like the talk stopper or whatever you guys call it?
Yeah, so you have the focus. You just have to make sure that you keep singing and stop listening to it being kicked back over the PA.
Yeah, speech jammer, that's it. Yeah, that's going to mess with me. I'm glad you told me that.
So you just need to focus. No matter what else is happening, you need to learn to focus on what is at hand instead of paying attention to anything else that might be happening. That's why we're doing this. Me and Brian have been talking for weeks about how to prepare you for this opportunity. And we've devised this completely prefabricated test to see whether or not you can handle it.
I want you to know, that the studio audience here of one thought that shit was hilarious. Brian sitting right over here was very amused, as was I. I apologize.
So anyway,
is everyone out of your apartment, Justin?
Oh yeah, no. Ayaz and Liz just had to get up. Ayaz didn't realize how late it had gotten, so he had to just GTFO. And as much as like I think we would have enjoyed a little bit more of Liz's perspective, just had to hit the road.
Okay, so it wasn't a case where like we were treading on dangerous territory or something.
No, I don't think so, because you know, this, like, that entire story is literally like just us fucking up and us admitting that like we fucked up. Like you can think that we're funny, but I don't think anybody can think that we're right.
Or that this is a cause worth going to war over. Jackie Hearn.
No, it wasn't a cause worth going to war. I mean, listen, like.
God damn it, Jackie Hearn. That was Jackie Hearn, just called it and blew that. nice.
It's just, I mean, listen, when it comes to that story, and we've told that story before, we've told it from our perspective. I just literally wanted to hear, like, Liz's point of view from, like, having to see, like, goodness gracious, booking at me. Like, yeah. You know, like, I was like, what the motherfuck? Wow, that's fast.
That's so weird.
You can see they cut it off at the exact moment that I see it and lose it. Wow, very fast. It was good. New Guardians of the Galaxy trailer. You want to see this?
Go.
when I left Earth. I had no idea what the universe had in store for me.
Our worlds are facing an unstoppable threat. You guys are our last chance.
I guess we're stuck together. Partners.
Are you telling me the fate of 12 billion people is in the hands of a thief, two thugs, a murderer, and a maniac?
This might not be the best idea.
We will not stand by as evil
wipes out billions of innocent lives.
Why would you risk your life for this?
Because by now, life's giving us a chance.
If we don't protect the galaxy, who will?
We'll follow your lead.
Oh, yeah.
A fake laugh.
It's real.
Totally fake.
I'm Groot.
Thank you. What is that?
It's a bomb.
And you leave it lying around?
I was gonna put it in a box.
What's a box gonna do?
You just wanna suck the joy out of everything.
Man.
Well, remember, I mean, listen, like we were like, oh, it's too serious. They got to sell that. That's the international trailer. So you're selling that to people that don't know cultural references, don't get American cultural jokes, and will be translated to every language there is around the world that they are going to sell that. So they're selling it as a space epic, which is the most marketable way to sell it internationally.
Yeah. Well, and also like little stuff like suck the joy out of everything or whatever. That's something they could translate to every local idiom. And the idea that it could be, they're conveying that there's going to be epic visuals and a big battle, but also that it's, non-traditional in that regard.
Yeah. I mean, it's got humor. Like it has humor that they assume will play in China.
Yeah, exactly.
People are saying Uga Chaka isn't American. Well, it ain't fucking Chinese or Taiwanese either. Like, you gotta fucking play it for
everybody. Yeah, everybody knows that shit's African. Look, you look over, you see a tribe, and they're... Hey, man, caller, you're on the air.
Hi, guys. I just wanted to say, fuck AT&T for cutting me off earlier. I wanted to finish my apology.
That's right. That was, and you know what? Say fuck AT&T for cutting you off right now again, assholes. Way to go, AT&T. Why did you drop that call? That sucks.
Wow, AT&T really is eating dicks tonight.
You know, AT&T is kind of an asshole. AT&T gets a couple of drinks into him, and then all of a sudden he doesn't have time for people just, to talk all that shit.
I know.
Fucking AT&T, man.
Starting to worry about AT&T's children. It's just...
Look, you let AT&T worry about AT&T's children, motherfucker. Shit's about to get, too real.
What a bunch of a-holes.
Is there anything else worth checking out before we wrap everything up?
I don't know, Allie. What are you enjoying on the web these days?
I'm bad at consuming things. I've just been making crap for the past few months. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Right. People are asking about titles. It's got to be Vowel Movement, right?
Yeah.
Vowel Movement. Let me pop this. Good luck and take care. And by good luck, I mean go fuck yourself. And by take care, I mean go fuck yourself. I've never checked out the e-cards thing. Is that just they have stock footage, you write whatever you want on that shit?
Oh, well, no. They made their bones having their own.
Yeah, they hired funny people from Twitter to write them.
That's awesome. And by hired, you mean just stole their tweets?
Yeah, probably.
I cannot believe you're going to be on Movie Clips trailers.
I think it was actually
that's
pre-Twitter,
so
though. Some e-cards.
I'm sorry. Thanks, guys. I'm pretty psyched. You're psyched. Yes.
God damn it.
What is going on?
That's me and Mr. Freeze. That's God damn it.
It's basically like a few Pantone shades away from being the same picture.
Let's see. What do we got here?
Oh, this is the new layout.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Nice. Man, you guys are tearing it up on Reddit.
On the subreddit.
Yeah.
God damn it.
At the mail route door, it is none other than Fast Talk and Gum Snap in Hollywood, Tom Merritt.
That's me, Justin. I actually, though, today I'm dressed up as a failed cable television network.
He needs you to find a new home with our friends over at
high school. You start breaking stuff and setting stuff on fire.
Are you cleavage Amish?
Thank you for my spooky juice.
Yeah. I've been drinking.
Oh, Alan came to my door and gave me this stuff. Comcast just ripped all the clothes off me and left me with nothing.
Oh, this is really weird.
God damn, I love those. I'm going to go back to the Reddit. Jizz, mate.
Robert, you is that the clips of us saying jizz?
If I didn't know better, I'd say you guys rehearse that. I need to, jizz, mate. I need to, jizz, Leo. Jizz. There you go. Cheers, mate.
Yeah, cheers for the British
accent.
Yeah,
traditional British. Cheers, mate. That was weird.
It's weird you brought it there, Leo.
Yeah, wow.
It's just, do you know what, guys?
Huh?
It's cheers, mate.
Oh my God, that was my favorite moment. Was he just looked over right at me and says, "Are you guys saying?" I was like, we're saying cheers, cheers,
mate. Cheers, mate. Yeah. Wow. What if Night Attack? No. I'm just talking. Man, I just want to. Goddamn. I just want to move into your. What the fuck? is this from last week's episode?
This is from Friday.
From Friday?
Yeah.
Deal with it?
Yeah.
This is amazing. You go, meow. Deal with it. It worked out so well, man. This is called a clumsy, apprehensive, and Andean cock of the rock. I don't know what that means.
What?
Whatever. I don't know. I just want to just dive in. Here we go. This is the kind of stuff. I don't know if it's going to be good or not, but like, this is the kind of stuff that I find where it says like, if the guys like my dick. Wait, Allie, are you familiar with My Dick Band?
No.
Okay. Real quick. I wonder if you could
been away from the show too long, Allie.
true.
Okay. Real quick. I'm just going to say, here, this is what they do. Get ready. This is.
My dick wonders why I call you all the time. What give you say? My dick don't feel the need to get such bodies away. My dick thinks I need help, but I know my dick's right. All right. My dick's just better off not listening to my dick's advice.
Here it comes, here it comes, here it comes. here's everybody my dick tonight.
That's well beyond Uncanny Valley. That's a real talent.
Yeah. So I feel like there's an opening here, which is an unfortunate turn of phrase since I was going to suggest it be my taco. Anyway, I feel like there's a, oh shit, stop playing. Shut up. All right, hang on, we got a caller on the line. Hey, caller, you're on, what's up?
Buck her right in the pussy.
All right. I walked into, I want to say like a, I think it was the local gas station grocery store, and they were playing Fields of Gold. Oh no! It was this morning. It was overnight. I walked into Baltimore Washington International Airport's rental car facility, and this song was playing.
You remember my dick when my West Dick moves and palm the dicks of Bali.
Dicks of Bali.
Fields of dick.
Yeah. But my favorite is this one. This is the one. It takes a while. Oh, Jesus.
Wait, did somebody not get my historic Stanley Cup goal call like set to the
Baker Street?
Baker dick.
Wait, somebody didn't get it? What do you mean? Like, didn't?
Well, somebody
see it?
Needs to cut that out. That's amazing. That was that was the most amazing goal call ever.
It really was. MyDickBand.bandcamp.com. All right.
Robert says, jury, the most amazing goal call was on Friday for my Kings. That's what I'm fucking talking about, dude. I called the goal for the fucking Kings to win the Stanley Cup, and then Baker Dick was playing, and then Brian faded up after I called the goal into like the soaring majestic wonder of Los Angeles' own My Dick Band.
Here you go.
Now this is the story all about how my life got flipped, turned upside down. And I'd like to take a minute, just sit right there. I'll tell you how I became a prince with a dick in my butt. In West Philadelphia, born and raised on a playground is where I put dicks in my butt. Chillin' out, maxin', relaxin', all cool, and all puttin' some dicks right up to my butt. When a couple of guys who were up to no good started putting dicks in my butt. I got him one little dick, my mom got scared, just had to move him with the auntie and uncle to get dicks in my butt. I begged and pleaded with her day after day, but she grabbed a dick and put it in my butt. She gave me a dick, and up my butt did I stick it. I put my Walkman on and said I might as well dick it. First class, yo, this is bad. Drinking semen dripping out of my ass. Is this what the people of Dick Butt live like? A dick in my butt. The way to hear the dicky butt and all that. Is this the kind of dick you're gonna put in my butt? I don't think so. I'll see when I get there. I hope you're prepared to put a dick in my butt.
Damn it.
He just like ramped up exponentially.
The plane landed, and when I came out, there was a dude like a cop standing there with his dick out. I ain't trying to get arrested yet, I just got here. I sprang with my dickness and jumped at his rear. I whistled for a cab, and when it came near, the license plate said butts and there were dicks in the mirror. Anything I could say that this cab was rare, but I thought, nah, forget it. Yo, dick, in my butt!
Oh my god!
Oh. I pulled up to the house about 7 or 8, and I yelled to the cabbie, yo, Holmes, take me later. Looked at my kingdom, I was finally there, sitting on my throne with a dick in my butt.
Jay wants this new Jaden Smith song is underwhelming. Oh, goddamn. T2G2 reminding you to join the conversation. Put a dick in your butt and tweet it with hashtag Night Attack.
Let me tell you, like, I am legitimately embarrassed for myself for finding that so amusing and, like, laughing to the point of crying.
I'm not fucking kidding when I say that, like, if lighting your farts on fire fucking played for audio listeners, that's what we would only do. Oh, we do understand that fucking people are paying $2,000 an episode to do the fucking duck, the ghost duck face.
For the record, my drummer has glued his hand to his ass on my show, so it's not much better.
Hey, man, we have to thank you for turning us on to Professor Shy Guy. Is he continuing to kick, like, 37 yes. varieties of ass?
Isn't he, like, so friggin' talented? I can't even handle it.
Yeah, in fact, the one thing that I really resent was that we weren't able to get a good Skype connection to him during our summer movie draft. So, like, some of his songs were a little bit hard to hear. Although when you call back on NSFW Line 3, I mean, your video now is freaking amazing. I don't know if you changed something.
It was just a bad connection the first time.
Apparently there's a new Tay cover.
All right, let's see.
Ooh.
What have we? Oh, this is on Tay's feed.
Wait, is this serious?
I don't know. I think it might be.
Because if it's serious, I feel like we shouldn't watch it.
Really?
I mean, because I don't know. I mean, like...
What a beautiful face I have found in this place.
Yeah, let me jump forward. Jesus.
Hey, she figured out Melodyne.
Figured out what?
Oh, auto-tune.
Shots.
Oh, shots fired.
No, it's fine. I use it too. Here tonight, there is music that sounds
on the string. I don't know the original song. I guess this is a cover of more popular song or some shit.
I've never heard it. Oh, for the record, I adore her. That was not shots fired. I just like heard her.
I don't know why you need to start
songs,
a fucking
like,
feud with Tay Allen.
Oh, God damn it. Allen, fucking
why
Justin.
Why can't you just be happy
asshole.
That you have a good career going with this Fandango thing and stop fucking just starting to light up fucking Tay?
Come on.
Join the conversation, ladies and gentlemen. Allie's shitting on fucking Tay.
Hashtag Night Attack. I was a fucker.
Here's my favorite part about the Join the Conversation joke is that, like, if you did it every 5 seconds, you wouldn't be doing it more than regular people try to abuse fucking Twitter. Like, it's funnier the more you say it.
You know what? I'm gonna look up real quick. Tweet deck. I'm gonna see how popular that shit is. Wait, can I just do that on what's a real time? Hashtag.
What are you talking about? Join the conversation?
Yeah.
But I mean, everybody fucking knows that there's literally no beef at all between like any element of fucking Allie or Tay or us or anything, right? We all know that, right? Good.
Yes.
Oh, you didn't know I wasn't actually concerned.
Night Attack.
just so it's said.
Okay.
Just so it's said. Oh my God, you guys, is it Transformer here?
Give me my alien gun.
Say hi to your mother for me.
Give me my alien gun. What are you talking about? Give me my insurance. There's a Transformers flying around. Give me my alien gun. I'm going to shoot you with it. Oh, my God, you guys.
So that's the, I forget who said it. but there was somebody.
Transformers round.
What the hell?
Right. I don't know how you'd spell the word scroops.
Scroops?
What do you mean Vibes? There's Transformers around. Maybe that Vibes is a Transformer. Transformers have Bluetooth?
Yeah, okay, I guess I just started this. who was it that said that, like, nobody could do an impression of anyone until somebody does an impression of it, and then everybody could do an impression of that impression? Like, that's what happened. The example that always pops into my mind is Dana Carvey doing George W. Bush. Or, I'm sorry, George Bush Sr. Like there is nobody had a George Bush.
He did
Bush
that
impression.
And Ross Perot, man. He also, like, especially for its era, like he made the fucking Ross Perot thing famous. Then everybody who did Ross Perot impressions did that. No, man, like fucking there.
I feel like that's all of South by So Wasted. Hang on, my black son is calling. Hello. Are you there?
Hey, Dad, how's it going? I just wanted to... Hey, Dad, can you hear me?
Yeah, no, I can. Go ahead. What's up, buddy?
Can you hear me?
Yes, go. Hello, can you hear me?
Fuck, are you black or deaf? Go!
Are you there?
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes. Talk.
There we go. Sorry, Dad. I don't know what's going on with my connection, but hey, I just wanted to say, did you get the flowers I sent you for Father's Day, for one?
What? No, wait. Did you actually send me flowers?
I could send you flowers if you give me your address.
Oh, Jesus. you don't get my address. You got to work up to the eldest son in order to make that happen.
Yeah, but I just wanted to also let you know that I'm, you know, taking off my shirt, about to make these
Jesus
ruffles burst.
Jesus Christ. All right. Oh, God damn it.
Taking off my shirt, about to make these ruffles burst.
Let me bust that open. Where is that? Somebody give me a link to something burst. Boo. I think Allie's my favorite part. Just dead center.
Is that Tom behind you? He's rubbing their stomach the whole time.
It's Tom.
Yeah, it's Tom. That's my favorite part. Hold on. He rubs his shirt.
God, that was the shit show night, right? There was one night where there was literally nothing usable.
Yeah. No.
We had nothing but talent in the room, and nothing came out but fucking squeals.
Probably. All right.
Get to the good verse.
Taking off our shirts, about to make these rifles burst. Taking off our shirts, about to make these rifles burst. Taking off our shirts, about to make these rifles burst. Taking off our shirts, about to make these rifles burst. Burst, 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 swag. Burst, 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 swag. Burst, burst, burst.
Man, I feel like this is a good what is Sarah watching moment.
Oh, yeah, maybe we should keep her on.
Pizza! God damn it.
Oh, man, that's not the song.
Oh, you, whoever it was that sent that in, you done did it now. All right, anything you guys want to cover?
Hey, BeanBoy89 says, Brian and Justin, I felt like a freeloader for the past 16 weeks. I finally become a patron. My mind is now clear. Well, good, because we've been talking about it. Me and Brian fucking actually had a conversation earlier today. We're like, man, you know who's a real fucking cunt? BeanBoy89.
Yeah.
Like, I'm sick of him fucking freeloading on our shit and fucking acting like he owns the place, being like, I'm BeanBoy89. I think you should do more comedy. Well, I'm like, motherfucker, you gonna have to pay me.
God damn it. Yes, that's all correct. This is that shit show evening.
Oh my God.
Man, you ready? All right, here we go.
Funkarius is asking if Jackie Hearn is there, and you are. Say hi.
All right, go ahead. Now tell.
Hello.
So turn down the music, because it's a wholesome American family sitting down to a...
Shots fired, literally, into Bonnie's uterus thrice.
That's true.
I'm uncomfortable.
Wow, what a weird place to come in.
Your old video. This is actually pretty funny. See, at least, and this is how you...
Is this a parody?
God damn, I'm like, shut up, other me. it's like my go-to tactic, and I guess I'm using it right now, is when shit, when you can feel yourself wasted, just toss to other content as much as you're able, as often as you're able. So this is why, if this is a shit show.
All right, hold on, all right. Wait, real quick. What would that track sound like?
Tell me more.
God damn, listen how drunk I am.
It bleached and tight.
Oh my god, that's horrible.
Oh no, I'm sorry, Brian. I was too busy focusing on how drunk you were as Ellie was serenading us.
How much more filthy could that shit get?
I would like to point out that was sung by the wickedly talented one and only Adele Dazeem.
Fuck, dating ourselves. Holy shit. Do we love the news or what?
Caller, tell me more. So tell me more. What's going on?
To answer Jerry's question, I'm in St. Petersburg, Florida.
That shit's gross. Get the fuck out of here.
Yeah.
You were wearing that's one sad.
You were.
Before they died.
We have a better.
At least we know
online.
Who the meme drunk is.
Ryan, you're on the air. What's going on, man?
Oh, yeah. Hey, I'd just like to know, how filthy is Allie going to get? I mean,
very filthy. Look at this hoodie. This is a very slutty hoodie right now.
Show us your belly button.
I'm doing the full-on Justin Bieber.
What a slut. What a slut. What a slut.
You're such an asshole, Justin.
Oh, my God.
100% of everything that you say.
Oh Lord, this is horrible.
I mean, they
this
say what happens is
watch.
When you get drunk, you just do what comes easiest. And we found that I am at my most easy. It is just me being horrible and mean to others.
And apparently, my easiest thing is make somebody else talk and say things interesting. I'm incompetent now.
Full on wet Justin Bieber tonight. That's what I am.
Did you say wet Justin Bieber?
I don't know. That's moist. It's friggin' horrible. I can't believe this is public.
She raced a Ferrari and slept with a Brazilian hooker.
I've done all of those things.
Canadian.
Oh, because it was raining. I'm soaking wet.
Guys. Guys. Sean hears us.
Talk, Sean.
I hear you. This is amazing. I love
the
internet.
Sean, silence. The council has convened because we're... Counselor Veronica, you will maintain your silence until the council hereby deems.
I'm not saying anything about you.
Hey, let Veronica talk. She's got something to say.
Shut up, silencer. All right.
I offer tribute. I volunteer.
Oh listen. My God. Fucking Brett's pouring whiskey into a
Guys, serious, we gotta be serious. This is serious. We've been called here for an important meeting. Ilir, what's your name, bro?
Hello?
Say your name.
Hey, fuckhole, say your fucking name.
You once called my name stupid on the NSFW show.
Good enough.
Well,
Ilir, stupid.
Dick face. Ilir, you just got a promotion.
Ilir, cunt dick face.
Step into my office.
Comes before the council. So let's talk.
God damn it, what are we doing?
What is your grievance?
What is my grievance? Oh, that's a good question. Gosh, I don't,
this is why we don't have fucking Poughkeepsians on.
Exactly.
All right, Mr. Jerry, you will maintain your tone silently.
No, he's right, though. Poughkeepsie's pretty miserable. He's
also,
not wrong.
Also, apparently, you're right. Poughkeepsie's miserable. Go ahead. God damn, are we drunk out of our fucking minds?
This is my favorite ad read.
This is so painful. Oh, my God.
I have no memory of this at all. Is all of this totally new to you guys? I remember that we got together. I cannot remember
no,
this
I
bit.
Remember regretting it. that night. I remember I remember thinking we were way too drunk, and that's saying something for the fucking for our normal South by So Wasted
lubricated
it's called South
shenanigans.
By So Wasted for sure. A reason because we get drunk and we live stream a lot. But even then, it was just like it was because normally there's at least one person who's coherent enough to kind of be the pivot,
keep everything going on. Sure.
And we just had, it was just fucking eight cows in a field, just fucking all just doing cow shit. Like, and then fucking taking calls, and the callers were all wasted, and they're just being like, and like the ones who were coherent, like, you can't fucking be like, I would like to ask Mo. I was just thinking, Mo, Mo.
Chimera points out that this is hours after dinner, and at dinner we were already wasted.
Why am I doing that?
Oh, so good.
My mom is crying.
It's a really great picture. I love that picture. Oh, you saw Blazer Tag when you came into town?
Yeah.
Was Alex Jones there with his kids?
That's what I was thinking. It was
oh, here, hang on, here. Grab yourself a mic there. Here, this is Brian in studio here. I'm giving him a mic.
Yeah, so on the way over, I saw the Blazer Tag, and it reminded me of Alex Jones and drunk Tom Merritt, who couldn't play Laser Tag.
Hungover Tom and Bianca.
Oh, sorry, not drunk, yeah, hungover. Yeah. So
it's pretty sad. Gosh, I feel bad. I'm taking the line.
Put on
I don't
a
have
real
anything.
Caller. Put on a real caller.
Like, look, I'm sorry. Let's put on one finally. On. This entire stupid night, let's have one real.
Pause it. Jesus Christ, my voice.
This, I'll tell you what, though, Brian. This is why you're brilliant. And this is why you are the fucking man that I have decided to spend the rest of my life podcasting with.
I choose you, Brian.
Because as shit-faced as you are, you fucking latched on to the one saving grace of the entire show, which was just see Ryan Alcott every time that Ryan Alcott calls in, pause, make a big production about stopping the show, and then let Ryan go. Like, that was like the one thing that you fucking had going for you. All of us were mooing, and you were the only one who had a fucking plan.
Well, caller, you're on the air. What do you got for
Ryan,
us?
Ryan,
all right. Let me tell you my goddamn grievance. All right. Like, people are not goddamn drunk enough, and they are not at SX.
His complaint is that we're not drunk enough.
Fucking South by Southwest shit.
I can't watching be
and they are not there.
We are doing Veronica, I show my belly button. Like,
excuse me, Ryan Alcott. I am out of my mind wasted. What are you like, judging?
Maester Jerry.
What a slut.
I kind of love that Justin look. I want that on an album cover.
That's called the Come Get It, Bro.
Is that what we're doing? We're all going to show our freaking belly buttons?
I will not. That's how drunk I am.
Oh, are we
I will show my stomach any second. I'm so drunk that I'm not going to show my belly button. That's how drunk I am.
God damn it. That's a thing that happened.
I'm so flossy. Bitch, get off me.
Not happening.
Hey, love on? All you guys.
God damn, I have no memory of any of this.
Oh, my God.
The fuck were we thinking? Hey, this is great. We're fucking embarrassingly ripped.
Why is this public?
We're like 12 Ambiens in. Let's get on the internet.
I'm never right, getting hired again.
Let's have finally a real call. The council is convened.
So there's not enough spoons being played during this episode.
Man, why don't you go spoon with Hitler's corpse, fuck up?
Why don't you go spoon with Hitler's corpse? That's exactly where you live instantly. Oh, you don't like this? You don't recognize the value of what we're doing? Fuck you. Why don't you go spoon with Hitler's corpse?
I just love, look at the passion in my face. Like, this is like, it's like the easiest thing in the world. Like, I'm finally exercising the muscle that I really want to. I just want to yell at people. It's all I ever want to do.
I love Hitler.
Actually,
I love Hitler.
Oh my God.
Actually, I think the caller has a very legitimate choice.
We have a very, we have an important caller on the hotline here.
All right. On the black hotline. All right.
Yeah. It's only for blacks.
What's up?
I have a very important joke to tell.
Go ahead.
All right. Oh.
An important joke to tell.
What? Just put the mic down, you idiot. Stop. What is brown and sticky?
My butthole. Good night. All right, next caller, you're on the air.
Cut her off when she has a microphone.
I just why didn't you give me a microphone?
She has a microphone.
Oh my god!
I'm like, uh-oh. Wait, did you realize it was Allie talking?
I think I did, but
oh, I got it now. Oh my god, I called into the show.
Yeah. Oh wait,
I was calling you.
That was amazing. Wow.
The answer was a stick.
Brown and sticky.
That's amazing. How did you know that?
Thank you. You're welcome. Man. That's my clean joke. I tell that at interviews.
Hey, Vince Neil is calling. Lead singer from...
Holy shit.
Fucking... Motley Crue.
Yes.
Caller on the air. Yeah. What's up?
Exactly. I was named after
Wait,
him.
Wait, what happened to the whiskey?
You were named after him? Yeah,
I'm disappointed that I'm not there in Texas right now.
Hey, buddy, what's going on?
Dope you have ever smoked.
He's fine. I
what's the best dope you've ever smoked? Is that the question?
I said I'm disappointed I'm not there in Texas because I'd be smoking the dopest dope you have ever smoked.
We're not smoking the dopest.
Prove it.
Wait, where is this dope?
I like to think that Allie was basically doing the equivalent of what we were looking for in Night Attack 2. She's basically like, show your scrote.
Yeah. That was great. I was like the definitive nature to prove it.
Wait, say that. Say that again.
Just add, like, just Allie, prove it.
Show your scrote. Oh, shit. Look at this. All right, Allie, look at this. Ever since you threw the hate on Team Tay, already they've created
Team Allie. <Yes. Allie. laughs> That's awesome.
God damn it.
Dude, I'll buy that. Somebody Teespring that shit. I'll buy that shit
tonight.
Yeah,
I'd wear the crap out of that, too.
I'll buy that for a dollar.
Hey, stop.
What is this? Wait, I'm waiting on something to load here.
That's the beautiful thing about Teespring. All you need is 30.
Beatboxing, is that what's happening right now?
God damn it.
Here's what I love is literally how many people like are paid to talk in this room and yet not an entertaining word is said like the entire time. We have so many people that are literally paid to talk and it's like just such a fucking waste. We are all so shit-faced.
I don't know. I mean, we say that, but God, we're all very white.
Brett looks amazing.
I'm impressed you fit that many people into this room.
Yeah, no, it was a wee bit crowded. It was a bit crowdy. I don't know if there's anything else worth. I'll just look at the end. Oh, I
think none of this is worth anything.
Wait, was that you?
Like it is just that is just the most amazing. Like it is the beginning of our live triple crown.
Well, and it's amazing. I can't believe this is our fifth fucking lap at Dragon Con.
Yeah, dude, we're like old hands.
Yeah, our fifth. People are asking where Bud Demon is.
No, Bud Demon was the night before. Shockingly enough, that was the sober night we were fucking podcasting was when Bud Demon fucking showed up.
Bud Demon shows up. Bud Demon lives in your heart. He's there. He's always there.
The thing about Bud Demon's got to be off screen. Oh, that's the funny part about Bud Demon.
There.
This is me, Bud Demon.
Oh my good God, Bud Demon, what's going on?
I'm having sex with a lot of butts.
Oh. So do you have sex with them in hell?
Yeah. I mean, I try to get them to hell, but sometimes you realize you got to do it on the street in front of
you go cruising for butts in the earthly realm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Would you say that you are teaching people asshole engineering in the bar and on the street?
I don't know. Sounds like a phrase that's probably copyrighted by someone.
Butt Demon, how old are you?
I'm old enough to know butts.
Well, I mean, would that be like, are you thousands of years old? Are you tens of years old? How old?
I am sure the first one.
What's your first memory?
There's my nanny, and she was gonna get me like some milk, and then she bent over, and I knew my purpose.
So you fucked her in the butt?
I mean, that would be inappropriate.
Okay, because you were just a child.
Right.
Oh, you're a child demon.
Right.
What did your father do for a living?
Yeah, he was a disciplinarian. He'd be run into, like, you know, a school and be like, who needs a paddling?
So he would come to other schools for which he didn't have jurisdiction and offered paddlings for children.
Right.
Is that something that you wanted to do for a living, or did you want to do something different than your father?
They accused him of undercutting the market, but it didn't matter because he paddled a lot of butts.
So he would do it for cheaper than us disciplinarians would do.
Sure, there are some jurisdictions they would pass legislation saying that you can't.
It would price fix the butt paddling industry.
Yeah. How is it important?
That was too much a reflection of Keynesian economics.
Well, you think about the monetary supply. There's only so many dollars to go around. We would take out like bond loans.
So what do you feel like your biggest lesson you learned from your father is?
That apparently business is in the butt.
But not the heart.
I mean, I have a heart on, if that counts.
I guess. I mean, a bit cheap, right? Like, you know, not a bit easy of a joke. You know, we're trying to have a moment here.
I'd hear you a little better if you bent over.
Like right now?
Yeah.
Do you just want me to show you my butt?
Hey, what are you, a cop?
Ladies and gentlemen, the butt demon. Everybody, let's get around. Right,
the butt. Right. Get the, in that shit. If I can put a bullet in its head.
Dude, butt demon's got legs.
Spread wide and bent over.
There's something to that butt demon character. I feel like, listen, like obviously we had the live character stuff that happened at Nerdtacular last year. That was like a big step for us. I don't know what we're gonna do for the night attack at Nerdtacular this year, but I feel like maybe the after show, I want a 60-minute conversation with the butt demon.
It's like the butt demon on, and it's like just about you're Charlie Rose and I'm the butt demon on. Like, well, the problem exactly. With the Catholic Church, I think they did a lot of stuff right. I liked how
war
they
in Iraq.
Excuse
your thoughts.
I mean, that's sort of like we fucked Iraq in the butt.
So you're pro.
What's that? Did you say pro?
Yeah, you must be.
I couldn't tell if you said pro or bro, and there's a big difference between the two connotations.
Indeed.
Man, it's late. Do we want to shut it down? Do you want to? You want to break down a video real quick?
I feel like we should just. I feel like we've done our thing. Although, if Allie wants to break down a video, let's break down a video.
Shit.
Lord, I tried to cut it off earlier before. I was like, oh, well, I'm sick, guys, can't stay a while. And then
you just
spend an hour embarrassing the crap out of me.
You'll work in the comedy mines until we say otherwise. Make the funny. yeah.
Now, Mitsula is like, Captain Morgan and the Butt Demon need to exchange conquest stories at Smoke Monster in 16 days. That can't happen because if you actually pay attention, the funniest parts of, or the person actually driving the comedy in Butt Demon and Captain Morgan
is always the straight
asking
man.
The questions.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it's just me and Brian growling at each other with obscenities.
Here, you want to see it? This is how shitty it'll be. All right, here's the Butt Demon and Captain Morgan.
Oh, Lord. Mary, what's going on? You're a fat fuck.
Maybe.
There we go. That's the butt demon meets fucking Captain Morgan. That's it. That's as far as we go where it's funny.
It goes nowhere.
All right. I say we go ahead and call it. That's amazing. All right. I'm going to shut it all down.
And I heard the harmonica, and I said, you're a fucking harmonica. You are a bitch, and I hate you. You eat piss, and then I eat dishes. I eat dishes because they're made of glass.
I really like the way you sing, Captain Morgan. Like I think you got some talent.
Yeah, I think you got.